Hi everyone, and welcome back to Ottanta Passione. I definitely had to wear something smart to celebrate the birthday boy. Happy birthday, Rafael Nadal, who today turns 35, but is like a good bottle of Italian or French wine. He gets better and better year after year, at least here in Paris at the Roland Garros. So today he played his second round against Richard Gasquet. The two of them know very well, and also Rafa has a total respect for Richard. Looking at the head-to-head, Rafa won all the previous 16 times. He only lost in 1999 when both players were still juniors. And here in Paris, played against Richard already in 2005 and in 2018. So just looking a little bit of the numbers, Rafa won in three straight sets with a score of 6-love, 7-5, 6-2, with 36 winners and only 23 unforced errors. There was just a little bit of a lack of concentration probably in the second set, and even when they asked him during the court interview at the end of the match, basically said, I had a fast start, an amazing first set where I believe that, you know, Richard was not playing that bad like probably the score would look like. I didn't miss anything, so I had, you know, the very, very high intensity. In the second set, instead, I lost a little bit of concentration, but this is part of our sport, so we need to keep focus. And the most important thing, you know, of course, is good for me to win in straight sets, but at the same time, probably facing some difficult moments, even during the first rounds. He helped me, even in the past, for example, recently in Roma, to take, you know, more confidence and probably to use these moments later on during the tournament. So for sure, he said it's a great victory against a great opponent. What we love of Rafa is the total respect that basically he has for all of the players over these 16 years. He has never changed in his attitude, in his determination, and the way, you know, how seriously he's taking basically each match. Regarding, you know, the first set, it was a completely one-sided set. Imagine that poor Richard Gasquet won only 9 points. Rafa did 12 winners and basically won the opener in only 24 minutes. It was a very humid and hot evening in Paris, 26 degrees. So imagine Rafa and as well Gasquet were both sweating a lot. Also, let's not forget that Gasquet made the quarterfinals here in Paris in 2016, losing to Andy Murray. The second set started, you know, with Gasquet managing basically to win the first game of the match after 35 minutes. It was the second one. And already in the fourth game, Rafa managed to get another break that he won with a beautiful drop shot. Probably everyone was considering that the match was going to be over very soon, but because, like I keep saying, tennis is the sport of the devil, Gasquet managed basically to save a set point in the ninth game. When Rafa went on serve basically to secure the second set, he was immediately love 40. He managed with two basically winners to close the gap, but after Gasquet took advantage of the third break point, so he went on a 5-4, and the following game he leveled the score on 5-all. At that point, in the 11th game, Rafa was once again on his serve 15-30 down, but he managed basically to win that very, very important game. And in the 12th, he got a break that meant basically winning the second set. He did it with a taking advantage of an unforced error of Richard Gasquet. So the second set lasts 62 minutes. At that point, the clock was showing 1 hour and 29 minutes. So for sure, I have to say that Gasquet started to become much more aggressive. He was trying basically to anticipate all of the shots of Rafa. In particular, he was hitting much more with his feet, inside the court, where probably for the majority of the first half, second set, he was too far away from the baseline. And basically, this game plan paid him back. And I have to say, he showed, a good intensity and a good level of tennis. So definitely a good effort from the Frenchman. The third set started basically with Rafa on serve. The match basically was going on level until the sixth game, when Rafa managed basically to get another break and he was leading the score 4-2. It was a very, very long game. Almost 7 minutes, and probably that was the end of the match. In fact, Rafa managed basically to keep his serve in the following game, and he break once again Richard Gasquet to close, this match. Of course, there is a total respect between the two of them. And as well, Rafa produced a convincing performance. Now, let's see, of course, like Rafa is aware, he knows how to win this tournament. He definitely needs basically to improve his level. I have to say, probably he needs to use more the forehand down the line. In these first two matches, I haven't seen him hitting that shot so much. And we all know that that basically is the thermometer, the indicator that shows, the confidence of Rafa during the tournament. But just looking at the other results, so at this point, Rafa will play in the third round against Cameron Norrie, the British player. They already played against each other in the third round of the Australian Open, and 1 month ago in the quarterfinal in Barcelona. In both occasions, Rafa won in straight sets. Just looking, at the other results of the day, Federer won against Cilic in four sets. I have to say, I was very, very impressed from Roger's performance. He showed a lot of variety, of course, very creative and entertaining tennis. He looked very, very relaxed, and he won in 2 hours and 35 minutes. The only time when he didn't look relaxed, it was when in the second set he received a time violation from the umpire, who apparently accused Roger, to take too much time when he was going, to the towels. Marin Cilic was ready to serve. It was a quite, funny scene, and probably I believe that Roger, after that he won very easily the opener with the score of 6-2, he lost the second set because of this moment. He was arguing quite a lot in his beautiful French with the umpire, and the third set probably was the turning point. Both players were serving unbelievable. They kept, their serving games to love, and they went to the tie break, and a double fault of Marin Cilic was the turning point, and in that case the Swiss managed to win the tiebreak with the score of 7-4. In the fourth set, Roger was very confident. He went to serve first, and he secured the match with a score of 6-2. I have to say, Roger really impressed me. Even if he said before the tournament that this is not his goal, the fact that he looks so relaxed, he can be a very threat for anyone. Now looking, at the table, he's going to play against the German Kopfer in the third round, who defeated the American Fritz, who unfortunately got injured, had to leave the court on a wheelchair. So I wish, Fritz all the best. He's a very good guy. He's a very smart guy. So recover very fast Fritz. And also Novak Djokovic, the world number one, won a very solid match on the Susan Langlen in his first meeting against Cuevas with a score of 6-3, 6-2, 6-4. He got broken very early at the beginning of the match, but after, was on fire and looking as well the fact that in the third round he's going to play against Berankis and in the last 16 against the winner of Cecchinato o Lorenzo Musetti, both Italians won today. It was very important because four Italians out of five won today. So Cecchinato won, Lorenzo Musetti won, Berrettini, Sinner, only Seppi lost. I believe that, for sure, 90% Novak Djokovic is in the quarterfinal from that top half of the draw. And for Federer, I think only between him and Djokovic, only Berrettini can try, to stop Roger. I have to say Berrettini has a game very similar to Cilic, very powerful serve and a very strong forehand, but probably the fact, lack of variety. I believe that Roger is still the favorite. Regarding, the other results, Diego Schwartzman won, so he's going to play in the third round against the German Koch Schreiber, who defeated in four sets the number 24 in the world, Karatsev, who, was just a semifinalist at the last Australian Open. Very convincing win for the German with a score of 6-3, 7-6, 4-6, 6-1, and also Alcaraz, the teenager who turned 18 years old in Madrid during his match against Rafael Nadal, managed to defeat Basilashvili, and he will play against Struff, who defeated in the first round Rublev. So very interesting. The winner of Schwartzman Koch Schreiber, we play against the winner of Alcaraz Struff in the last 16. And like I mentioned earlier, Sinner won as well, and he will play against the Swedish Himer, who defeated basically in four sets today, Gael Monfils. So also just going back to the women, Iga Swiatek won as well in 61 minutes with a score of 6-1, 6-1, because Iga is very precise and she likes respect these kind of numbers. Now, joking apart, in my previous video, I talk about the scenario with the women. At the moment, in terms of a favorite, only Serena Williams and Sabalenka are left from that side of the draw. And on the other side, there is Svitolina, Sofia Kenin, and Iga Swiatek. So let's see. But I believe probably we might have a very big surprise once again at Roland Garros regarding the women. Instead, looking at the schedule for tomorrow, the bottom half will be back in action. We're going to have Ruud against Fokina, starting, at 10 local time. Sorry, 11 a.m. local time in Paris on court 14, after Fognini versus Delbonis on the Suzanne Lenglen, Nishikori against Laaksonen, the Swiss qualifier, Zverev against Zere, the Serbian, quite promising player, Giron against Garin, Johnson, the American, against Carreño Busta, Opelka against Medvedev on the Suzanne Lenglen lunchtime, and closing in the night session, Stefano Tsitsipas against John Isner on the Philippe Chatrier. So it's going to be a very interesting day. It's only 5 days since the Roland Garros started. We had so many upsets for the women and as well for the men. Dominic Thiem went out, Andrei Rublev went out, and as well today Karatsev. So stay tuned. For sure, I believe probably at the moment the strongest players are on the top half. It's such a shame that the big three are all on the same side. I still believe that from the bottom half, Stefano Tsitsipas is the favorite to reach the final. To discover that, you just have to stay tuned here on 80 Passione. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video with whoever is in love with tennis, but in particular with Rafael Nadal. See you tomorrow, vamos a celebrar! E Rafa ha ganato, ciao!